So thanks for coming in, Butch and Frank. Appreciate you guys both coming in this morning. So as we talked about the last time we spoke, we have come up with a concept to build a cooking show around you, around your restaurants, and what you guys do. You got three successful restaurants. You got a fourth one on the way. We think you're a great personality. I know you come from a long line of chefs and cooks in your family, and we see a concept of a cooking show being built around the making of the cooking show, and maybe incorporating some of your family into it, possibly shooting it right in the restaurant.
They want to film me, they think I'm crazy, they think I have character, that's fine. I'll make them do it, as long as it doesn't affect my business and it doesn't take more time than I need.
We think that if you can be yourself and you can act naturally, you can run the restaurants, we can even shoot the show right in the restaurant and capture what goes on one of your busy nights in your places.
Give me Paolo here. I need Paolo. Yeah, okay. I need Paolo.
When we first approached Butch about the opportunity to shoot a cooking show, he was reluctant and said he's just too busy. He's managing three restaurants. He's got a fourth one on the way, 140 employees, and he just didn't know how he would manage it all.
Mike, it's getting busy. We've got a lineup at the door. It's getting busy. We've got a lineup. Let's go.
And we realized that that in itself was the show. The show was going to be about a guy managing his three restaurants, his employees, and that he just got himself his own cooking show.
Tell Alfredo to go with table 38. And tell him to make sure there's five pizzas on that one.
What people don't see when they see these cooking shows is where the chefs generally come from, where they have built their reputations on, and what goes on in those restaurants on a regular night.
You never see what goes on behind the scenes. Yeah.
You always see the cooking show, but you never see where the chef came from or how he got to where he is.
I didn't believe in it at the beginning, and I thought it was crazy, and I went more along with it to make other people happy. But now, the more I'm getting into it, I'm excited, and I want to see succeed.
What happened here? A feast. What are you breaking? And you put it back? What are you putting it back for? If someone gets it, they're gonna hurt themselves, they're gonna cut themselves. Go put it in the garbage. Jesus Christ, man, what's wrong with you?
I started working in restaurants when I was 11 years old. I was working for my uncle. He had a restaurant, and he needed a dishwasher on the weekends. So I would go in on Saturdays and Sundays and wash dishes. I was making $5 a day. When my uncles first came over from Italy as children with my grandparents, they were 11, 12 years old, and that's the only jobs they could have got.
I think your rough around the edges thing is charming.
Wow, okay.
I think you got that Italian flair, you got the personality, you got the attitude, you got a bit of a temper. I've seen it on a couple of occasions.
Yeah. Growing up as a kid, one of the highlights was Sunday dinner. My mother used to get up at 6 o'clock in the morning to come up with different recipes and things to cook for us, because we were in the restaurant business and she was always trying to impress us. We would love him so much that we would take those recipes and bring them back to the restaurants that we used to work at, and we used to look like stars thanks to my mother.
One meatball, one calamari, one rapini, and one olive.
That's where it all started, and it started with every branch of our family, from the cousins to the nephews to the brothers and the sisters.
We wanted to show the real Butch. We wanted him to be himself on camera and let us do the rest.
Guys, the entrees are a hit tonight. Billy, they knew you were working. Entrees flying, baby.
Best calamaris.
Best calamaris they've ever had. 24. First.
24 best calamaris they've ever had.
The stress of a restaurant business is the coordination to make sure that the customer's experience from when he walks in to when he leaves is perfect. I think in the restaurant business, that's the biggest struggle, is the management of people. Basically, restaurants is it's a daycare.
Okay, Louis, just work, man.
Yeah, I understand. But since when
you're paid to work. Just work. Tell him to come here. Tell him to come here.
The door has to cross over the oven to go and do his job on the fresca. I don't believe it. So turn there to do the fresca.
Alfred, what's going on over here? Hey, what's going on over here?
I have to come here.
No, he's got to do it. He's got to do it.
But he's making me do it. I don't understand.
What's he doing? Stop it. Make him do the pizzas. You come here and do this. Right.
Yeah, but I have four pizzas in the oven.
Pull him out.
Four pizzas.
Pull him out. There's only four pizzas. Let's go, man.
You're dealing with everybody's problems on a regular daily basis. It's like taking 20, 30, 40 employees, and they're always trying to defy the rules.
What's that? How long have you been working here?
They told me
no. How long have you been working here? I want to know how the fuck long you've been working here. Okay, what's our house policy on earrings over here? One earring maximum, not both. Go and take it off.
If you're not meant to handle this kind of stress, and if you don't love what you're doing, you will be a failure. That's for sure.
Get me Paulo over here. Paulo. Mike.
Yeah.
Okay, don't get pissed.
Yeah.
The osobuco was an osobuco puts in.
Fuck off, man. I don't have time. I'm in the fucking shit.
Where the fuck is this guy, man?
Mike is a soldier that you always want to go to war with. He's a good friend, and he understands me, and I understand him. And it works very, very, very well.
Come here. You see this, okay? It's 3 inches tall, right? Is it 3? Okay, and it's braised and it takes long in the oven, right? So when you make a mistake, why are you writing regular osobuco? It's a busy night, we've got lamps at the door, and you're making mistakes like this. It's not normal. Give me Frank over here. Here, give it to the dishwasher.
Working with Frank is very energetic. He brings a certain energy to the whole thing. And for me, he's my security blanket because I'm rough around the edges and sometimes I don't know how to express myself. And Frank always holds me back and tells me the right way to do something in a situation, or he takes care of it for me.
Priority is always the clients and the business first, you know what I'm saying? That's our bread and butter.
That's why we'll always do it after hours, before you open, after you open, on the weekends when the restaurant isn't open.
We're filming action shots during a rush, during the intense moments and all that. How does that affect
the clients? How is that going to affect
the clients? It's probably a Saturday night, right?
This is a one-time shot, a one-time deal that they...
This is live. This is reality TV. It's live. And we want to capture what goes on a Saturday night during a rush hour.
You know, my concern is the camera crews, filming during our rush. I mean, it's quite intense. As long as they don't interfere, they're not in the way, and we can do our business, like we usually do, I don't see, a big concern besides that. As long as they don't get in my way, I think we'll be okay.
It's like a hand in the glove. Couldn't ask for a better partner.
But I got the wings on 25,
Hey, Paul, almost is making mistakes. You got me a regular subwoofer and you're trying to make it in. Cut his tables.
Bush, the wings are up for 25.
Bill, play it for me. Let's go. I need to get out of this shit. Asparagus and zucchini, that's all. Where's Nunzio? I need Nunzio here. Nunzio!
Well, we wanted to take a completely different approach. A normal cooking show, we wanted to take it more reality. We wanted to show you really what goes on behind the scene in a restaurant on a busy Saturday night. And how it takes, what it takes a crew to film something like that. So you get to see all the type of approaches, what goes on in the back of the restaurant and what goes on for a filming crew to actually film it. When I first met Butch, I didn't think he was going to be able to pull this off. But, man, he got me wrong. He is fantastic in this. I think we got the true personality from him.
Paolo, but what's wrong with you and your Osabuco? What's wrong with you and the Osabuco? I don't have no friends, you understand? Nobody's my friend.
You know, in this kind of business, in the restaurant business, you know, it's all about passion. Butch is he's a special guy.
Wow. Mike, look at this.
Well, listen, I mean, we could start. We could try to do it and see where it takes us. I mean, there's no use not trying. We might as well just try it.
I think, obviously, we'll probably have to meet a couple more times and go more into details on what we need to do, what's, you know,
if you guys are open to the concept and open to the idea that we're pitching to you here, what we'll do is we'll go back and we'll put together a plan, a timeline, how often we need to shoot, what kind of crew that we need. We have a lot of work to do, putting a budget together, putting a concept together, really detailing it. We'll review it with you, and we'll tell you when we're ready to start. But we could probably start shooting within the next few weeks.
All right. We're good, man. We're good. Everything's under control, man. We're good. Joe, can I ask you a question? Over here, you're asking for a hazel salad, extra gold cheese, easy on the cheese.
Yeah.
So are you making fun of me, or you're a little bit on the...
No, just put less cheese.
But you're asking me for extra gold cheese, and then you're telling me to go easy on the cheese. I don't understand. Is it me? Am I stupid? He's asking for extra gold cheese, and he says easy on the cheese, so I don't understand.
Instead of the gorgonzola cheese, she wants...
But you're talking about the gold cheese. Yeah. Extra gold cheese, easy on the cheese.
So she wants...
You're not getting it. You're not getting no cheese whatsoever. No fucking cheese on that salad, you understand?
Rock and roll?
Rock and roll, man.
Very good. I got, I'm getting good stuff on you guys, so let's keep on rocking and rolling.
Mike, I still don't understand nothing. Did we give?
39, we went. The side Parmigiano was.
Pomodoro, it went?
Yes.
Okay, that's all I need to know.
I wouldn't want to put him on a camera and tell him to memorize some lines. He doesn't seem like the type. But if he could just be himself and just do what he does.
Wow. Mike, look at this. Mike, look at this.
What?
Hey, what are you doing? It's time to work now, not time to eat! You understand?
And really introduce the potential audience to the recipes, the food, the things your mother's taught you, your grandmother's taught you.
It's time to work! Not time to eat! Get to the front!
Butch is,
what's wrong with you, man?
He's a special guy. A one of a kind. But a great guy, a great partner. And I wouldn't replace him by anybody else.
I know half of your family lives in Italy and you go over there on a regular basis to try out new things. These are the things you've told me, and this is how we came to this idea of this guy could be on TV. This guy should have his own
show. No matter what I do is with passion. That's why it comes out a little rough and loud and whatever. Mm-hmm. It's just the emotions. Mm-hmm. That's all it is.
Tonight I'm going to choke someone, eh?
Well, who now?
Mefiz, he's eating in the corner. He's having pizza while the restaurant's full.
I already told you, fire.
Jesus Christ, man! I can't fucking take this anymore.
Just get rid of
him.
Don't waste your time firing him.
Okay.
It's as simple as that.
Give me two arancinis, a calamari, and a paparazzi.
At the end of the day, you have to believe in people that work for you and people work with you. A lot of times during the rush, we say things that we end up regretting at the end, but it's fun, though.
My friend Billy. Bro, I'm gonna buy you a beer tonight, eh? Two beers. Billy's a killer.
Time is not a factor because you're so caught up in the moment and serving the people the best you can and managing the staff and taking care of the clients. It's a very hard thing to do, but for us it comes very easy and very naturally. It's the only thing I know to do. I've been doing it since I was 10. It's the only thing I know to do.
Look at the cameras, Butch. Stand by. Action.
Today at Mercury Rising, we'll be making dinner consisting of two incredible dishes that will knock your socks off. We'll start with an appetizer of burrata and tomato. Burrata cheese is unbelievable, and I will talk all about it later on. The second dish is a gnocchi alla salvia cipolla. This is homemade ricotta-based gnocchi with an onion and fresh sage sauce. These gnocchis are much lighter and fluffier than the traditional gnocchi. So let's get to it. First thing we'll do without wasting any time is we'll put the water to boil for the gnocchi later on. As we start now, you'll see that this recipe is very easy and simple. It's based on two major components, which is the ricotta, which is a regular container of 456 grams that you find at any local supermarket. Equal parts of flour, and a little trick, you could use the ricotta container to measure. It's two equal parts. 1 teaspoon of black pepper, 1 teaspoon of coarse salt, and 1 teaspoon of nutmeg. 1/2 cup of Parmigiano cheese. Then we take our ingredients and we mix them up in the bowl. As you mix, you'll notice that the moisture is gonna get absorbed by the flour. After we take our hands and we knead it as if we're making dough. We'll take a little bit of flour, we'll sprinkle it on our counter, and we'll take our mixture and just transfer it. What we do now is we just solidify it as if you were making dough once again. We add a little bit more flour, and now we start the process of flattening the gnocchi base into about 1/4 inch thickness.
Cut! That was a take! That was good until there. Go wash your hands. Good.
They don't want. They don't want. They want the black one.
Stand by! And action!
What we'll do is we'll take the knife and cut them in 1/4 inch strips. Trust me, once you boil these gnocchis, they'll be so light and fluffy, knock your socks off. This recipe, which is meant for two, could also be doubled for 4 and tripled for 6. Now our gnocchis are all cut. What we'll do is we'll just add a little bit of flour to separate them. We'll transfer them to our bowl. The excess flour is very important because we'll need that to loosen the gnocchi from one another. Then we'll just ripple our fingers right through them, and with the excess flour, the gnocchis will separate nice. We just made gnocchis in 3 minutes flat. We'll put these gnocchis aside while we wait to make our sauce. So this sauce is salvia e cipolla, which is sage and onion. First thing we'll do is we'll get our pot warm while we cut the onion. We take the onion and we julienne it, standard procedure. Take 1/4 pound of butter, put it in our hot pot, you see that sizzling? And we throw our onions inside. What we're trying to create here is the base for the sauce. While we wait for that, we'll start with an appetizer of burrata and tomato. Here we have our burrata cheese, vine ripened tomatoes. Burrata cheese, which comes from southern Italy, mostly from the regions of Basilicata and Campania, has a hard mozzarella exterior and a creamy interior. The name burrata means buttery in Italian, hence the taste of the interior of the cheese. So we'll start by taking some ripe tomatoes, and we'll slice them. It's important to cut your tomatoes first because of the creamy interior of the burrata cheese will spew onto the tomatoes. So we take our tomatoes, we lay them down on our dish. We'll take some fresh black pepper. Sprinkle, of course, salt. And olive oil, extra virgin always. Now with the pièce de résistance, the burrata cheese, Because it's creamy interior, we have to put it on the plate before we actually cut it and separate it. Now we take a knife and we separate the burrata cheese in half. As you can see, the creamy interior, which is where the buttery flavor is. Once again, we put some olive oil, black pepper. Now we finish this quality, fantastic appetizer with some fresh basil. And there you have it, pomodoro burrata. Very simple, but very delicious. You could always serve it with some fresh crostinis. Complements it well as you spread that cream on the crostini.
Cut! Frank, action!
Now we put the appetizer on the side and we should get back to our sauce, which the onions are almost caramelized to perfection. While we finish this off, what we'll do is we'll take our gnocchis and submerge them in the water. The little secret about gnocchi is when the gnocchi start to float, that means they're ready to be served. In boiling any pasta or gnocchi, it's always best straight from the water into your sauce. So while the gnocchis are boiling, we'll finish up our sauce. What we'll do is we'll add 2 pinches of black pepper, a pinch of salt, not too much because the butter releases a lot of salt, and we'll add our fresh sage, about 3 teaspoons. As you noticed, I put the excess flour into the pot of boiling water because we'll be using about 1 cup of this water for a base of our sauce in our caramelized onions and fresh sage. Now that our gnocchis have reached the top and are boiling on a consistent basis, we'll take 1 cup of the water from the gnocchi with the excess flour and we'll add this to our sauce. This will act as a thickening agent for the homemade gnocchi. Now we'll strain our gnocchis, we'll take them out and throw them in our sauce. As our gnocchis are incorporated to the sauce, right before we serve, we add some fresh Parmigiano cheese. We incorporate that together. And voila. You have gnocchi, which are light and delicious, alla ricotta, with fresh sage and caramelized onions. We could always top it up with a little bit of fresh sage. And it's that easy. Effortless, easy, quick, fantastic dinner. For 2, for 4, for 6, buon appetito.
Cut! It's a take.
We're done? Wow. Get out of here.
Your name is Mercury, right?
Right.
We came up with the name Mercury Rising.
Oh, like the thermometer.
Like the thermometer.
Yeah, yeah.
Mercury Rising, a little bit of a play on words.
All right.
So we'll give it a shot. I'll take that as a yes.
Oh, let's do it. Let's do it.
We'll put together what we have to put together.
I feel like I'm crazy right now, but let's do it.
Starts the crazy.
All right.
How's it going?
Make it!